Hello children. Children, today we are going to read a short passage about a girl named Salma. Salma was a very brave girl. She likes to help her parents. So, let's read a passage.
Children, listen to the passage carefully. Brave Salma. Little Salma decided to help her mother to clean the house. She and her pet dog Moti followed mother into the drawing room. First, they dusted the furniture. Then, they cleaned the kitchen. There was a cupboard filled with jars. Salma, be careful. All those jars are made of glass, said mother. Yes, mother, I will be careful, said Salma. Later, they watered the plants in the garden. While running around, Salma fell down and hurt her knee. Mother quickly closed the tap and went in to get some cotton. She cleaned the wound with the cotton and told Salma not to touch it. Salma was a brave girl. She smiled and said, "Do not worry, I am fine." She picked up a flower fallen on the ground and gave it to her mother and hugged her. They both went back into the house and sat down to read a story. After reading the whole story, Salma went out to play with Riya and Shyam. Salma was very happy about how she had spent her day.
Children, now I am going to read a passage again, so you will be listening to this passage more carefully. Brave Salma. Little Salma decided to help her mother to clean the house. She and her pet dog Moti followed mother into the drawing room. First, they dusted the furniture. Children, dusting, to remove dust with the cloth. Yes, many times you have seen your parents also doing it, isn't it? And nowadays, I'm sure you must be helping your parents to dust the furniture. Then they cleaned the kitchen. There was a cupboard filled with jars. Salma, be careful. All those jars are made of glass, said mother. Yes, mother, I will be careful, said Salma. Later, they watered the plants in the garden. While running around, Salma fell down and hurt her knee. Mother quickly closed the tap and went in to get some cotton. She cleaned the wound. Children, wound means injured, and told Salma not to touch it. Salma was a brave girl. She smiled and said, "Do not worry, I'm fine." She picked up a flower fallen on the ground and gave it to her mother and hugged her. See how nicely she said thank you to her mother. See the gesture. Children, do you say thank you to your parents? Yes, you should say thank you to your parents, children. They do so many things for you all, isn't it? They both went back into the house and sat down to read a story. After reading the whole story, Salma went up to play. Children, I hope you are also reading a story every day. See how nicely Salma read a story with her mother, isn't it? You should also read a story every day, at least one story every day. Salma went up to play with Riya and Shyam. Salma was very happy about how she had spent her day. Children, nowadays, what are you doing? Yes, are you spending your time reading books, helping your parents? I hope you all are helping your parents. You are reading book, you are doing the CW and HW which we are sending you. Yes? Do you understand the passage? Now, in that passage, there were some common nouns, proper nouns and material nouns which we have done. Yes, we have sent you the videos of common nouns, proper nouns and material nouns. In this passage, I said Salma went in the kitchen to help her mother. Yes, kitchen is a room in our house. It's a common noun. So, we are going to write the word kitchen in common nouns column. Yes, we are going to write a word kitchen in common nouns column. Next, I said little Salma. Yes, I am talking about a specific girl, a particular girl. Yes, her name is Salma. So, Salma is a proper noun. Yes, Salma is a proper noun. And we always write a proper noun with a capital letter. We always write a proper noun with a capital letter. Salma is a proper noun. Then I said all the jars were made of glass. Yes, glass is the material which is used to make jars. So, which is the material noun in the sentence? Glass. Yes, glass is a material which is used to make jars. Children, I am going to send you a PDF of this passage. There are some common nouns, proper nouns and material nouns in this passage. You are going to search the common nouns, proper nouns and material nouns. You are going to write in this way, make 3 columns and write it properly. I hope you all have understood the passage.